Dear students, in this lecture, I will discuss about the addition of nonpolar reagents. So, we have already discussed about the nonpolar reagents. Nonpolar reagents of class A, like H2, addition of O2, addition of multiple bonded compounds, addition of SiH bond, SiCH bond, and CC bond, these are the kind of nonpolar reagents. So, how these nonpolar reagents can oxidatively add to the metal center, we will also discuss its mechanism. In this lecture, we will also discuss its mechanism, that is concerted mechanism, three center mechanism. We have already discussed, studied in the previous lecture, that is concerted mechanism. So I will discuss first about the different reagents addition that are nonpolar reagents in the methyl center. These oxidative addition reactions of nonpolar reagents is the different step of catalytic cycles. Actually, this oxidative addition reactions of nonpolar reagents, they occur in different catalytic cycles intermediate steps. So, what are that catalytic cycles? They are olefinic, alkynes, arene, hydrogenation reactions. We will discuss in the homogeneous catalysis. So, in the homogeneous catalysis, we go to the homogeneous catalysis, we have to know certain terminologies like oxidative addition reactions, like reductive elimination reactions, like migratory insertion reactions, because they are catalytic cycles, and in that catalytic cycles, these are the intermediate steps. Which are the intermediate steps? Oxidative addition reactions, reductive elimination reactions, migratory insertions, these are the intermediate steps. So likewise, this addition of nonpolar reagents is the intermediate step of various catalytic cycles of olefinic, alkynes, arene hydrogenation, and hydroformylation reactions. So, in hydroformylation reactions, as I have already uploaded this video on homogeneous and heterogeneous catalysis. From there, you can understand about the homolytic catalytic reactions, in which they occur via cyclic processes, and these cyclic processes, the oxidative addition reaction is the main step of homogeneous catalytic reactions. So these cycles, they includes hydrogenation and hydroformylation reactions. These are the two main compounds which are extensively used to study the addition of nonpolar reagents, and these reagents are Waska's compounds and other is Wilkinson's catalyst. So Wilkinson catalyst and Waska's compound, you will study in the homogeneous catalytic processes. So these two are the main reagents, main metal centers, which are having the lower oxidation state of this metal. They are coordinatively unsaturated compounds, so they can easily used as the catalyst in homogeneous catalytic processes. And the first step of these reactions is generally oxidative addition of these nonpolar reagents. And generally, this nonpolar reagents, they can add to the metal center via cis oxidative addition. So the nonpolar reagents, they add to the metal center through as a cis product. They give rise to a cis product. So they adds to the metal center at cis position. So in this reaction, we will discuss the oxidative addition of SiH. This is nonpolar kind of reagent, and in this reaction you can see that this is the iridium complex. It is having one oxidation state, and this kind of compound Et3SiH, it is oxidatively adding to this complex, and then you can see that it can form this kind of compound having 6 coordination number, it is having 4 coordination number. The oxidation state of iridium becomes 3, and here the cleavage of SiH bond takes place, and at the cis position SiEt3 and H, they are cis to each other, and they added oxidatively to this complex. This is a kinetic product, and if we see the thermodynamically stable product, and this will be this where the CO is the this is also this acquires the equatorial position, the planar position, so this is thermodynamically stable product. So generally these two, they join via cis position, they join through the cis position, but here in the thermodynamic stable product you can see the position of this carbonyl changed to the planar position. Now in this example you can see the oxidative addition of H2. So this is again the iridium complex, this is the this is the iridium complex we have already seen, and this is the Waska compound, and in this the addition of H2 takes place through cis addition, and here you can again see that the coordination number of iridium becomes 6, it is previously it is 4, and oxidation state will increase, and also the electron count will increase by 2. Now we will see the example of oxidative addition of CH bond. So this oxidative addition of CH bond is of two types, may be intramolecular CH oxidative addition, or may be intermolecular CH oxidative addition. So in this example I will show you the intramolecular oxidative addition of CH bond. Now you can see that this is a azobenzene, and here you can see that this bond, this CH bond will activate, and this CH bond will going to add this carbonyl, and then you will see the oxidative addition reaction. So from here this carbonyl group is attached, so this carbonyl is oxidatively add with this is the activation of CH bond. So this is a kind of intramolecular oxidative addition reaction. In this second example you can see that in this there are 3 triphenyl phosphine ligands, and one of the triphenyl phosphine ligand it will activate, and you can see that here due to activation of CH bond of this phenyl group, there are the 2 phenyl groups are here and 2 phenyl phosphines are here. This is 1 phenyl phosphine and triphenyl phosphine, and in this triphenyl phosphine 2 phenyl phosphines are these, and 1 phenyl group is here. This 1 phenyl group, there is activation of CH bond, so this CH bond is oxidatively add, this is CA and this is H bond, so it is oxidatively add to this IR center, and you can see that 3 coordination number is this, 1 Cl and 2 PPS3, 1 is this and 1 is this and 1 is this, so there are total 6 coordination number of this this center. So this is a kind of intramolecular CH oxidative addition reaction. Now this is the example of intermolecular CH oxidative addition reaction, and in this reaction you can see that Ru is having 0 oxidation state, and when this is added to this compound, this hydrocarbon, then you can see that this hydrocarbon it oxidatively add to this Ru center, its CH bond will activate, and its H bond will added to this Ru, and the other moiety will added to this Ru. So this is a kind of oxidative addition, but it is a kind of intermolecular oxidative addition of CH bond. Here the DMPE is 1,2 base dimethyl phosphine ethane, it is Me2PCH2CH2PME2. So this is this PME2CH2CH2PME2, this is DMPE, and this is a kind of oxidative addition reaction, that is intermolecular CH oxidative addition reaction. And this is the example of oxidative addition of CC bond. So you can see that I have written this CP star means this is cyclopentadienyl ligand, and it is written as C5ME5. And this addition of this cyclopropane, initial this is CH addition, and this product will form, and then finally this CC bond insertion takes place and this kind of product will be formed. So this is oxidative addition reaction of CC bond. Primarily this CH bond addition, and then this will open, this bond will open, and then CC bond activation will takes place and CC bond oxidative addition will takes place. So this is a kind of oxidative addition reaction with non-polar ligands. Now we will discuss about the concerted mechanism, that is the addition of a non-polar reagent to the metal complexes through oxidative addition reaction. So that mechanism will explain how this oxidative addition will takes place. So this is the concerted mechanism or three center mechanism for oxidative addition of non-polar reagents. So if this is the non-polar reagent and this is the metal center, then in this case you can see that if this metal center is 16 electron system and if its oxidation state is 0, then in the first step you can see that this AB non-polar reagent will be added to this metal center, and this addition, this is the slow step in which addition of this non-polar reagent will takes place to this metal center. So this is the first step. And in the second step you can see that again we can see if this is the square planar complex, we assume that this is a square planar complex with 16 electron system and 0 oxidation state, and in this mechanism first this non-polar reagent will add to this metal, and this step is known as addition step. And you can see that in this step the electron count will increase by 2. If it is 16, then it becomes 18 electron system, because this AB will donate its electrons to the metal center. So this becomes 18 electron system. However, its oxidation state will remain as such. Its oxidation state will remain as such because in this first step, this non-polar reagent will give its electrons to metal center. Okay, so this is the addition only. In the second step you will see that now this metal center gives its electrons to the sigma star of AB and thus break the bond between A and B. In the second step you can see that the bond between A and B break, and this A and B, they can easily oxidatively add to this metal center. So in this reaction, in this step, you can see that metal is giving electron to the sigma star of AB bond, thus breaking this bond, and thus its oxidation state will increase. Here its oxidation state will increase. So the second step is called as oxidation step. The second step is oxidation step, because electron remains the same but the oxidation number increased by 2. You can see, again I am explaining that in this concerted mechanism, this is the three center complex. So formation of three center complex takes place first. In the first step, this metal complex adds this AB. This AB will give its electrons to M. Thus, its electron count will increase, but the metal's oxidation state will remain the 0. Here you can see the sigma bond formation. After this step, the second step proceeds through oxidation. And here the metal will give its electrons to the sigma star of AB bond, thus break this bond. And
it becomes M0 to M2 system. Here oxidation takes place. So you can see that in the concerted mechanism, first addition and then oxidation will take place. So this is oxidative addition reactions, but the first step is addition and the other is oxidation, or total is the oxidative addition reaction. So I am giving one example. This is the simple without the metal complex. Now I am giving the example with the help of a metal complex. So this is a IR complex. Again, it is a Waska complex. L is PPH3. So we have shown with the L. So this is square planar complex. This is 16 electron system. And in this, IR is in plus 1 state. So if H2 is added to this, so you can see this H2 is, we are adding hydrogen to this. So this is hydrogen. So we are adding hydrogen to this. So if we are adding hydrogen to this, so first, in the first step, this hydrogen is adding and giving its electrons to the IR. So it becomes 18 electron system. The geometry becomes trigonal bipyramidal. This is an intermediate type and it remains, its oxidation state remains plus 1. And after this, this metal center, it can give its electrons to this HH bond, thus break this bond, and this will oxidatively add this hydrogen and this hydrogen. Then you can see that because this metal is transferring its electron to the ligand, so it oxidizes, and it oxidizes from first to third IR metal. So you can see that this step is addition, which is the step, this is addition step, because H2 is added to this, and in this step, this is oxidation step in which IR will oxidize from IR1 to IR3. So in this concerted mechanism, first step is addition and the second step is oxidation. Overall reaction is oxidative addition, where the number of electrons, they are increasing, the electron count is increasing, the oxidation state is increasing, and the coordination number is also increasing. But the mechanism, you have to remember this, that the first step is addition and the second step is of oxidation. So this is the concerted mechanism through which the nonpolar reagents, they adds to the metal complex in an oxidative addition reaction. So these are the different points which you have to remember about the concerted mechanism of nonpolar reagents. So it's a three-center oxidative addition reaction. So this is the conclusion of this whole story of nonpolar reagents. So how these nonpolar reagents added to the metal center is the first is the three-center oxidative addition reaction. Concerted mechanism is three-center oxidative addition reaction. In the first step, addition takes place. In the second reaction step, oxidation and breaking of HH bond takes place. How this breaking takes place? The strong back donation of metal to the sigma star orbital of AB bond. And this is a second order reaction. Because this is a second order reaction. Why? Because in the first step, two reagents, their concentration affects the rate of reaction. The first step was slow, that is of addition. So two reagents are there, hence it is a second order reaction. The reactants should be coordinatively unsaturated. Again, this is the point to be noted, that the reactants, or means metal complex, should be coordinatively unsaturated, and the addition through the concerted mechanism will be cis addition. The non-polar reagent will add it through cis, through the cis positions. So this is all about the concerted mechanism of non-polar reagents. I think you can understand. You have to remember two or three points about the concerted mechanism, that it requires coordinated unsaturation site. It causes cis addition. It is second order reaction. The first step is addition and the second step is oxidation. So thank you very much for listening the video patiently.